Welcome to the Storm Watch 9 webcast early on a Friday morning and your November 1st. I am meteorologist Kevin Skarupa. A band of rainfall moving through overnight. You will notice two other bands of rain back to the west. The second one moving through western parts of New York currently before sunrise is the one that has the really strong wind with it, although we've had a couple of power outages already with some wind gusts over 30 miles an hour. It will be a wet start to the day, a mild finish with winds expected to kick up at times over 40 to 45 miles an hour. So there are a few counties under wind advisories, but a couple of gusts over 40 to 45 miles an hour, not out of the realm of possibility. Temperatures will jump quickly with winds out of the southwest this morning, turning to the west behind that front after 2 o'clock this afternoon. We get to about mid-afternoon and skies will start to clear in western areas first, but we're going to have to get through a couple of downpours and maybe even one or two rumbles of thunder along with those wind gusts. But things will start to diminish later this afternoon and this evening. Skies clear overnight, setting up partial sunshine for both days over the weekend. There will be a system moving through later Saturday evening, which could have a couple of rain showers around initially, changing to a couple of snow showers before it wraps up early on Sunday morning. Much colder wind for Sunday after a mild day tomorrow. Temperatures still tomorrow jumping anywhere between 55 and 65, but we're talking highs mainly in the 40s with a gusty wind out of the north for the day on Sunday. So warm with morning rainfall. It starts to die down after 1 o'clock, but winds could kick up at any point today, gusting over 40 to 45 miles an hour. Some clearing late in the day with temperatures ranging between 64 in Pittsburgh to 72 in Nashua. Still fairly mild tomorrow with temperatures running above the average, but once that chance of a couple of snow showers moves through as we fall back on the clocks and daylight saving time ends, we look at highs in the 40s for Sunday and beyond.